Hello guys, welcome back. Today our topic is about how to calculate circuit breaker size and breaker size calculator with solved example. So let's move to our topic. According to NEC National Electric Code and IEC International Electrotechnical Commission and IEEE Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers, a proper size of circuit breaker is must for all electrical circuits, i.e. residential wiring and industrial or commercial installation, to prevent the electrocution hazards, fire, and protection of the connected electrical equipment and appliances, for maximum safety and reliable operation of the electrical machines. It is recommended to use the correct and suitable size of a circuit breaker according to circuit current flowing through it. If we don't use a correctly sized circuit breaker, so in case of other hour or lower size, instead of correct size circuit breaker, the circuit cables and wires, even the connected devices, may heat up, or in case of short circuit, it may start smoke and burn. That's why correct size circuit breaker is needed for smooth operation. In this post, we will be going to show that how to choose a right size circuit breaker for electrical wiring installation and design, with related voltage level, wattage, usage, and difference in percent to the circuit load and current capacity of the CB. So how to find the right side of circuit breaker? Here are the table of content which we will discuss in this video. So number one is, what is a circuit breaker? How does a circuit breaker work? And number second, circuit breaker size calculator. And third number is, circuit breaker size calculation for single phase supply. Number four, circuit breaker size calculation for three phase supply. Number five, circuit breaker size calculation for continuous and non-continuous load. And what good to know about circuit breaker? And then seven is, circuit breaker size percent and ampere chart. So the first topic is, what is a circuit breaker? A circuit breaker, CB, is a control and protection device which control, make, or break a circuit manually or by remote control under the normal and fault condition. Break a circuit automatically under fault conditions like overcurrent, short circuit, etc. A circuit breaker is used for switching mechanism and protection of the system. A circuit breaker is a switching as well as protection device used for on and off operation of the circuit, as well as prevent the electric shock. For accurate operation and the protection, even complex designs are used with circuit breaker, like fuses, relays, switches, earthing and grounding, etc. So here are the symbol of circuit breaker. This is 1, 2, 3, and 4. These all are the symbol of circuit breaker. So next topic is, how does a circuit breaker work? In normal condition, when the circuit current rating is lower than the circuit breaker rating, the circuit operation is normal and it can be changed by manual operation. In case of fault or short circuit, when the value of current exceeds the circuit breaker current, it will automatically trip, i.e. break the circuit from the main supply. So if we use 100 ampere circuit breaker for 30 ampere circuit, it won't protect the circuit from fault currents and may burn and damage the device, as more than 30 ampere current won't trip the circuit breaker. In short, we must use the proper size of circuit breaker according to the device. For example, circuit breaker should not be lower or nor highest but 125% of circuit current. Next topic is circuit breaker size calculation for single phase supply. To determine the appropriate size of circuit breaker for single phase supply, it depends on multiple factors like type of loads, cable material and environment, temperature, etc. The general rule of thumb is that the circuit breaker size should be 125% of the capacity of cable and wire of the circuit which has to be protected by the circuit breaker. Let's see the following short example. Example 1. Suppose a 12 gauge wire used for 20 ampere lightning circuit having 120 volt single phase supply. What is the best size of circuit breaker for that 20 ampere circuit? So solution is, and circuit breaker size, what is the circuit breaker size? We will find this circuit breakers size should be 120% of the circuit current. So 125% multiplied by 20 ampere, so 1 is equal to 1.25 multiplied by 20 ampere. So the size is, circuit breaker size is 20 ampere. Now let's see the example number 2. What is the appropriate size of circuit breaker for 2000 watt single phase 120 volt supply? So solution is, load is equal to 20,000 watt and voltage is equal to 120 volt single phase. So current, circuit current according to the Ohm law, I is equal to P divided by V. I is the current and P is power, where V is the voltage. I is equal to 2000 watt divided by 120 volt. So the answer is, current will be 16.66 ampere. Circuit breaker size, simply multiply 1.2 or 1.25 to the load current. So here we find this current, so the answer we will get through 1.2 multiplied by 16.66 ampere. So the answer is, circuit breaker is equal to 20 ampere. So now let's see the example number 3. What is the suitable size of circuit breaker for 230 volt 1840 kilowatt dot single phase circuit? So solution, let's see, current is equal to power divided by voltage. I is equal to, I means current, 1840 watt divided by 230 volts. So the answer is, 1 is equal to 8, I is equal to 8 ampere. The minimum rating of circuit breaker should be 8 ampere. The recommended size of circuit breaker should be 8 ampere multiplied by 1.25 is equal to 10 ampere. So next topic is circuit breaker size calculation for three phase supply. To find the breaker size for the three phase supply voltage, we must know the exact kind of load, as there are many factors affecting the load current. In other words, same rule won't apply to the different types of load. For example, light, motor, inductive or capacitive load. As motor takes initially very high current during the starting process as well as power factor involvement. For residential use, we may follow the same formula as above for single phase with taking the under root 3, which value is 1.732 due to the three phase for power formula. Good to know. As we discussed above the point, good to know. The good to know is here for the same load, the breaker size in three phase is less than the breaker size used in single phase AC circuits. Let's find the correct size of circuit breaker for three phase circuits as follow. Example 1. Which size circuit breaker is needed for 6.5 kilowatt three phase 480 volt load? So solution, power in the three phase P is equal to V multiply by I multiply by under root 3. So let's see, 1.25 multiply by 7.82 is equal to 9.77 ampere. The next closest standard of circuit breaker is 10 ampere approx. Find the example. Let's see example 2. Find the appropriate size of circuit breaker for 3 phase 415 volt 17 kilowatt load. Solution. So here current is equal to power divided by voltage multiplied by under root 3. So I current is equal to 17,000 watt divided by 415 volt multiply by 1.732. So current will be 23.65 ampere. The recommended size breaker 1.25 multiply by 23.6 ampere is equal to 29.5 ampere. The next closest value is 30 ampere. So here we will use 30 ampere circuit breaker. Let's see the next topic, circuit breaker size calculation for continuous and non-continuous load. As circuit breakers and our current protection device are designed for 100% rated current. For example, a 30 ampere circuit breaker can safely carry the exact 30 ampere current, but NEC suggests, National Electric Code suggests, this is the standard, NEC is a standard, suggest 80% as a safe current limit as compared to the rated current of circuit breakers. This is the value, this is because all loads are not same, i.e. some loads are simultaneous continuous while other are non-simultaneous non-continuous. In case of continuous load for 3 or more hours, the load current should not exceed 80% of the rated current of the circuit breaker. The 80% of a 30 ampere circuit breaker is 24 ampere. This way, a 30 ampere circuit can be safely used for 24 ampere circuit. In other words, a load circuit having 24 ampere, the appropriate size of breaker would be 24 ampere divided by 0.8 is equal to 30 ampere. Example. Let's see the example. Circuit breaker for 30 ampere non-continuous load. An exact 100% rated for 30 ampere circuit breaker can be used for 30 ampere non-continuous load. Example 2. Circuit breaker size for 28 ampere continuous load. In case of continuous load, rate of percent 125 is applicable. 1.25 multiplied by 28 ampere is equal to 35 ampere, as we will use 35 ampere circuit breaker. Example 3. Circuit breaker size for 30 ampere non-continuous load and 28 ampere continuous load. 125 percent continuous load plus 100% non-continuous load. So here 1.25 multiplied by 28 ampere plus 30 ampere is equal to 75 ampere. Good to know this topic, as we suggest above. Good to know what is good to know about circuit breaker and our size circuit breaker for protection can damage the water heater or other connected appliances even leads to the fire due to overheat. And this is an authorized breaker or same rating with load current breaker can trip and reset the circuit again and again. Use the correct size breaker. A single phase circuit breaker cannot be used for three phase supply voltage levels. A three-pole circuit breaker can be used on three-phase system using either two or three poles. A three-pole circuit breaker can be used on single-phase system only and if indicated by the marking or instructed by user manual. 30 ampere breaker and 10 gauge wire can be used on 240 volt AC supply. Breaker cannot be larger than capacity or ampacity of wire except for some load like more loads. In addition, a circuit breaker rated for 120 volt can only be used for 120 volt. 240 volt can be used for 120 volt, 240 volt, but not for 277 volt commercial appliances. 120 to 277 can be used for 120, 240 and 277 volt. 120 volt cannot be used on 240 volt circuit breaker and vice versa. 15 ampere 120 volt cannot be used on 20 ampere 120 volt circuit. So here we end our topic. Please subscribe our channel for more information about electrical technology. Thanks for watching.